for me. So John Hicks was and is my closest doctor friend from kind of the moment I met him. I knew that we really saw the medical world, the act of healing, the way of looking at patients exactly the same. I 100% trusted his judgment and his clarity and his wisdom, and I trusted and trust his heart. He is a compassionate, kind, good man, and a wonderful doctor and a wonderful healer. And I so appreciate him. So the night that he died, actually, you know, we've been hearing these different conflicting stories, and I thought that he had been airlifted to Florida and he was going to be okay. And Star and I were at a restaurant and it was overlooking the bay. And we, I looked out over the water and the sun was setting, and there was literally this huge column of light coming up from the sun into the sky. And I turned to Star and I was like, "Do you see that?" And she said, "You mean the column of light?" I said, "Yeah." I said, "That has to be significant." And it didn't go away really fast. I mean, it lasted like 8 or 10 minutes. And I believe that actually was about the time that John was making his transition. And I believe he was riding that wave, just like, "Farewell, everyone. You know, I am on to bigger things, but you know, this is a big universe." It was so remarkable and so beautiful. I've never seen anything like that before. But it was very much like John. And many lovely things have been said about him, and you know, I can repeat some of them. He was deep, he was compassionate, he was fun-loving, he had such a passion for life, he had such a great, beautiful love for Betsy. He had a great, beautiful love for Jesse and Mia and Joey and his patients and children in general. He really, really cared and was committed. And then he was also silly and playful and in the moment and fun-loving and very deep and very wise and a man of great integrity. And underlying all of that, I think the thing that I most admire about John is this inner core of peace that he had that was just rock solid and dependable. It was the essence to me of who John is. So I've been asked to offer a blessing to close this part of the ceremony. And the best blessing I think that I have to offer is the blessing of the ways that each of our lives has been touched and transformed by our connection with John. And knowing that that connection still exists outside of space and time and is part of eternity and the eternity of the connection of who we are. And I'd like to bless John on his expanding journey and joyful journey, and let him know that we deeply appreciate the ways that he blessed each of us with the grace of his many remarkable qualities. It will be a blessing to all of us if we could internalize the gifts that he offered and make them our own and expand upon them in our own unique ways. This is what he would want, is that we keep growing and growing in the wholeness of ourselves and in our unique ways. So on John's behalf, if I may be so bold, I wish that each of us can continue his legacy of love, compassion, integrity, healing, and sheer goodness. May we all be illuminated by this beautiful soul and his remarkable life. Amen.